So I'm sure you guys have probably noticed by now that Cosmos seems to be coming to the MGM Resorts portfolio of properties. Let's see how we can take advantage of that here on Ace of Vegas.
It's the Ace of Vegas, the Ace of Vegas.
Before we get started, I just wanted to give a special shout out to our Patreon members that help keep us independent and growing. More on that later.
It's chilly out there. Hey there, Spinners and Sharks. It's Vegas here, and I hope you're doing well. So, the news broke early last month that MGM Resorts has brokered a deal with one of their flagship competitors, the Cosmopolitan Las Vegas, to add the property to their portfolio. Yes, Blackstone Group has decided to sell the property and its operations for a sum total of $5.65 billion, and $1.625 billion of that was MGM Resorts money that they used to purchase the hotel operations. So while they won't own the property itself, they'll certainly be running the show. Which does make sense given that they've sold off their other flagship properties and the land that's on them, like the Bellagio, the Mirage, and MGM Grand Las Vegas, but they still run hotel operations under the MGM Resorts umbrella. Well, that's the abridged version of what's happening here anyway. From what I understand, the deal is still tentative in many ways, and there's still a few details to hammer out. But frankly, you guys already knew that. All the major news articles and vloggers have already beat this story to death, and you don't need me to break it down Barney style for you. But what we do need to do doesn't have anything to do with real estate investment trusts, has nothing to do with the Nevada Gaming Control Board, or some other third arbitrary logistical thing that we normally cover. No, this all has to do with comps. And now that Cosmo is going to be part of MGM, what's going to happen to all the comps, and are they going to get better? And the answer to that is, maybe. So before we address the gold coin-shaped elephant in the room, let's talk about casino rewards programs. I've talked about them at length on the channel before, but at this point we just want to focus on a few details. If you didn't already know, a casino rewards program is functionally like a King Supers card, but for casinos. They're designed to build loyalty and help reward the player, theoretically. The casino uses it to track you, or more accurately, your spending habits, whether they be on the gaming floor, in the club, at the pool, or at whatever random celebrity restaurant that's associated with that portfolio of properties. In exchange for this behavioral contact and casino loss information, you're usually rewarded with certain perks that are called comps. These complimentary items range from percentage discounts and coupons to free stays on properties, waived fees, free gifts, and even all expense paid transportation to and from the property of your choice. Every casino has one, and both Cosmo and MGM Resorts are no different. Up to this point, Cosmo's had their identity membership and rewards program, and the MGM Resorts has had their M Life rewards program. So since MGM has purchased both the hotel and casino operations portion of things, at least nearest I can tell, it seems to me that they'll be taking over the rewards program as well. So it's quite possible that identity memberships will be turned into MLife memberships. Let's talk about whether that's going to be a good or bad thing. Now the good news here is that MLife members are going to get a brand new 5-star property to enjoy. Cosmo's got over 3,000 rooms, 100,000 odd square feet of gaming space, a giant spa, dozens of eateries and bars, and a great pool, all with great reward opportunities for both gamblers and resortists. And Cosmo members should, inversely, gain access to a large gamut of properties. So if you're tired of purple and artsy at the Cosmo, you can watch fountains closer at the Bellagio, feed dolphins at the Mirage, or dig your toes in the sand at Mandalay Bay. Now here's the bad news with that. They're gonna have to find a way to fairly convert all identity members into MLife members. Now that's an issue for two reasons. Reason number one, the membership levels and progressions are different between the two programs. And reason number two, the perks at each individual level also seem to have some stark differences that are inherently something that we're gonna find conflict with. Let's go ahead and go over just the progression as is. A good example of the progression differences in the perk levels are MGM Resort's Pearl level compared to the Sterling level over at Cosmo. So to get to Pearl at MGM, you're going to need 25,000 points to be a member of that club, whereas you only need 4,000 points to become a Cosmos Sterling member. So immediately it's clear we're looking at two different point systems here. But there is an easy conversion here because both of these programs reward on-property spending of money instead of just gambling, and that's going to be our saving grace. So it's a relatively new thing in casinos to do this, but strip properties often encourage non-gamblers to participate in their gambling rewards programs by also rewarding them for how much they spend. For example, with Cosmo, for every dollar you spend on property, whether it's renting a room, eating and drinking, or even hitting the spa, you earn 5 identity points, whereas with M-Life Rewards, you earn 25 points for every dollar you spend. You see where I'm going with this, right? It's basic currency conversion. At this point, 25 M-Life points functionally convert to 1 American dollar. Conversely, that same American dollar converts to 5 Cosmo identity points. Meaning if you multiply your Cosmo points by 5, you get your M-Life points equivalent, or what they should technically be converted into. And based on those point levels, you can calculate what tier you'd end up at. Meaning in this case, the Sterling tier would start at about 20,000 M-Life points, Gold takes you to 100,000 M-Life points, and Platinum is a whopping 250,000 M-Life points. And therein lies the problem.
Sterling doesn't even take you to the Pearl tier, that's 25,000 M-Life points.
Gold gets you easily to the M-Life Gold tier, no worries, as M-Life Gold only needs 75,000 points compared to the 100,000 you'll probably have from your identity membership. And an Identity Platinum way overshoots the 200,000 points required on M-Life to make M-Life Platinum. So I know that was a lot of math just now, but we'll probably end up simplifying things. I'd say we'll, like we're actually working there. I know there was a lot of math right there, but odds on, M-Life and Identity are probably going to end up simplifying things by just doing an even status match from tier to tier, just to make life easier for everybody involved. So for all intents and purposes, we'll be matching Velvet to Sapphire, which is basic. You're going to be matching Sterling over to Pearl, which is pretty even. Gold to Gold, and then Platinum to Platinum. Pretty sure Noir doesn't exist on the Identity membership, and if it does, I'm sure they'll sort that out. But regardless of the tier and point matching, we still run into a problem. Pound for pound, it looks like Identity membership is just better than anything that M-Life offers, and currently, for a lot of those tiers, it's a bit cheaper. I mean, the Sapphire and Velvet benefits are about the same. You get like 10% off here, you get 5% off there, a couple special room rewards every once in a while, no worries. But just by being a Sterling member, you get twice the points gambling on machine games as you would just playing on a regular Velvet membership. Whereas Pearl with M-Life only gives you a 10% point bonus. And then that's not factoring in the guaranteed free rooms, the 2-for-1 tickets on the buffet, or the 2-for-1 tickets on the Opium show at Cosmo. And I guess you get free parking with Pearl, but you also get free parking with Sterling anyway, so again, that's not really that big a deal. And I can already hear the comments now, but Ace, I'm a valued high-level player at the casino. Won't my play be factored into my tier match too? And to you I say, yeah, probably will be. But we're not really calculating that right now. There are a lot of variables there. It depends on what game you're playing, how long you're playing it, how much you bet, yada yada yada, your level of play, your skill level, all that jazz. Trust me, your hosts will figure that out. We're not here to work on that today. That's too much to calculate. We're just going apples to apples from what we have publicly available on the website, especially for non-gamblers. But honestly, at this point, it seems like M-Life players are getting the best of this deal, and the Cosmo players are getting the worst of the deal, or the hostile corporate takeover. Either way, take your pick. But before we wrap up here, I do want to address one X factor. It's what we built this entire channel on. That is the My Vegas comps. Yes, the growing collection of slot apps that promise you free slots and real rewards to use in the casino. And for the most part, they actually deliver on the promise. The series is up to 7 separate games now, distributed evenly between PC, Android, and iOS systems, and offers at least some reward for almost every M-Life property in the States at least, if not the world. Now, some properties like Signature, Delano, and Nomad aren't directly supported by MyVegas, or at least not anymore, because they're considered hotels within hotels, but the parent properties of Mandalay Bay, Park MGM, and MGM Grand, respectively, are all already represented, so that kind of sorts that out. But looking at it, Cosmo is a property on the same level as Bellagio, Aria, and Vidara, and it would make the most sense that Cosmo will have its own category. Especially considering how thin the Vidara rewards have been looking lately, I can see Cosmo taking its place very easily. And while this isn't related to whether Play Studios gets a deal for Cosmo rewards or not, this would be a really great opportunity to get rid of the odd man out on the My Strip feature by replacing the Balloon Circus sprite with the Cosmo. And since I know Play Studios watches my videos, take that back to your boss. This is what the people want. But only time will tell if Cosmo is actually inducted into the My Vegas skyline, or if it's going to maintain its legacy some other way going forward.
Okay, Spinners and Sharks, that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed today's editorial and found it informative, I'd appreciate a like, and consider subscribing if you haven't already. Once again, I want to thank a special group of Spinners and Sharks that are continuing to support our work on Patreon. Guys, it means the world to me that you're willing to support me in this way and keep me independent of the fluctuating YouTube algorithm and its random ad rates. If you're interested in supporting me directly, I have a link to the Patreon in the description box down below. But in the meantime, do you plan on visiting Cosmo now that it's part of the MLife portfolio? Or are you a Cosmo player that may abandon ship if the rewards don't look nearly as good? Whatever your thoughts may be, I'd love to hear them in the comments down below. Until next time though, this is Ace of Vegas signing out, wishing you all strong hands, and of course, happy spinning, you guys.
Viva Ace of Vegas. Viva Ace of Vegas. Viva Ace of Vegas. Viva Ace of Vegas.